Communication is the key to life. Communication is the key to love. Communication is the key to us.
There's over 1,000 ways to communicate in our world today. And it's a shame that we don't connect.
How many types of communication do you think there are?
A lot.
A lot? Okay. Why would you say a lot?
Different type of languages inside like different like places in the world. Like Dubai has their own language and stuff. Chinese and Japanese people have their own language.
Well done. So what we're going to talk about today is effective communication and enthusiasm. I'm going to jump to the end of the title page and talk about enthusiasm. Can anybody help me tell what enthusiasm is? A little louder, Trinity? Give me some more enthusiasm. What is it?
Like encouragement.
Encouragement, okay. Encouragement works. What else? So would you say I'm very enthusiastic whenever I'm around you all? So how am I?
Because you're like
passionate, excited. What else?
Smart.
Thank you, sir. Wow.
Loud.
Smart. What else? Loud. What else? Positive.
Energetic.
Energetic. I think that's the best word when we think about enthusiasm. Guess what, achievers? We want you to have more enthusiasm at all times. Enthusiasm when it comes to your identity. Enthusiasm when it comes to being able to communicate. Why is it important to have enthusiasm when you're communicating? What's so funny? We all want to laugh. What's up?
Oh, no, I was smiling because my yogurt is good.
What type of communication was that?
Verbal.
No. What was it?
Classroom speaking.
Nonverbal. Thank you, sir. That was nonverbal communication. Do you believe that? Okay, now, in a question form. What do you think the most used type of communication is?
Social media.
Social media? What else?
Sign language. I want to say verbal is like up there, but it's second.
Verbal is up there, but it's second. You're on your theme this morning, sir. 85% of all communication is nonverbal. 85% of communication is non-verbal. Yes, sir.
Is that bad?
You tell me.
No.
I mean, it's good.
Yes.
I get it.
It's why.
Because it depends on how it's non-verbal. Like, you can, like, be like this and show you don't care about something. And then, like, sitting up and paying attention and showing you care about something. So, I don't know. If you, like, if you.
All right.
So, people interpret what you're doing in different ways.
People interpret what you're doing different ways.
Is it like body language and sending mixed messages to people and teachers?
Spot on. That's exactly what it is. What else?
Yeah, when people say like they're like looking at you and then they say like they can tell what you like. I don't know like how to explain it. Like, it's just like when you look at somebody, you can tell what they think.
You sure? Yeah, exactly. What else are you?
Reading people's lips.
Reading people's
lips. Like, even when they're not talking, like, you know how you had, like, a TV show, it's like lip sync battles. Mm-hmm. You can, like, read what they're saying.
Give me a universal nonverbal communication.
Smiles.
A smile. What does a smile mean?
Yeah.
I'm happy. Give me something else. Give me more. These. What else? Exactly. What is this?
Saying
hello. What else? I'm waving the white flag. I surrender.
Guantanamo.
In most places, right? Hasn't worked so well in the United States in the last couple of years with the relationship with law enforcement officers, but this is a universal sign of kind of like I submit. Anything else? What about some bad ways of nonverbal communication that people use? Thank you, Trinity. What does rolling our eyes mean?
You got an attitude.
You got an attitude. I am disagreeing with that. I am avoiding that or whatever.
Bucking at someone.
What does bucking mean? What does that mean?
Like, you want to start something, or like, you just, let's say someone's staring at you for a long time, and it's annoying, you buck at them, they back up a little, they want to get over there, or something like that. You let yourself feel like you are more superior than the other person by bucking at someone.
Exactly.
Hand gestures.
Does anyone know what this means? What did you say?
I've seen it before.
You've seen it before a lot. Alright, so I'm a member of Omega Psi Phi fraternity, also known as Q-Dubs. Right? So these are paws, and we put paws up like this, throwing these up, to show that we are members of a fraternity. And this is a universal symbol just for our fraternity. Anyone doing this that is not a member of our fraternity could be some issues, correct? But this is how we communicate in places where no one else knows what we're doing, and we are having a conversation about, okay, I know where you are. And we have other ways that are nonverbal. I've been able to communicate with people in a room like this that are my fraternity brothers and have a whole conversation because we have nonverbal ways of communicating.
So it's like sneaking and talking in class.
Well, I want you to think about it. I don't want you to think about it sneaking and talking in class. I want you to think about it on a larger scale, right? On a larger scale. Yes, ma'am.
Sorry.
So,
you
step shows, community service projects. And, you know, we can talk about fraternities and sororities later, but this is one of the advantages of going to a four-year college, that you can join a fraternity or sorority. And most likely, you can create friends for life, right? So, very similar when y'all just took these work assessments and skills assessments. Most often, members of the same fraternity share the same values in life, right? So, we do national projects in the community. We have talent hunt programs here in the city. We give out scholarship funds. Whoever has talent this year, you will be participating in the Mega Sci-Fi Talent Hunt. We cut checks for $1,000 for anyone who wins our talent hunt programs. We also have scholarship programs where we give about $500 to $1,000 to each kid that applies and wins. Last year, we gave out $4,000 for Lynchburg City School graduates that were headed to college for scholarships. Now you see how that nonverbal communication just took y'all to a silence when I started talking about opportunities? That's how I want you to understand about what effective communication is. People are talking around you.